Was good, y'all. Ritzos in the building, and today I just want to say thank y'all so much for God giving me this opportunity to be able to bring this to y'all. I hope y'all are having a great Monday, y'all. Back to school, everything is going well. But man, as y'all can see by the looks of the title and the screen, today I'm going to be showing y'all the first ever and the best version of this well-rounded wing build coming at y'all on NBA 2K22. Now, when it comes down to this build, I literally went by every single stat in order to maintain the build name and also being able to get contact dunks, pro dribble moves, and then on top of all that, the takeovers we get are going to be pretty nice as well. So again, I just want to say thank y'all for those of y'all who decided to come through. But man, y'all already know what y'all need to do. Be sure to hit that sub button if you're new. Anybody looking to join the RGF Rich Gang family, go ahead and hit that like button. Let's go ahead and get 50 likes on this video. I know that we can do it. And definitely go ahead and turn on post notifications. Do not forget to do that. I'm telling you, I'm going to go ahead and drop y'all a lot of content this year, just like I did in previous years, y'all. So let's go ahead and get right into the making of this. And not to mention, I upload every single day, y'all. I'm on that grind, so do not worry about it. Quality content coming right at y'all and the most fire possible. Now, go ahead and put this wing build under the small forward position. Then when it comes down to the height, weight and wingspan, I'm gonna be real with y'all, this part is really going to be optional. You can take risk here if you want to, but for my liking, 6'7" is going to be the absolute best weight as well as the height to go with. Then when it comes down, 180 and a 7'4" wingspan. Now you could go with 181 if you want to, does not make much of a difference, but if you go anything higher than that, it's going to start affecting your physicals and your speed, y'all. That's what we don't want, so go ahead and leave it like this. And now let's go ahead and get into the actual stats of this build. And remember, I went back and forth with every single category, and honestly, the build name continued to change until I made it exactly perfect how I liked it, and I'm telling you, you are too. So let's go ahead and get right into it. When it comes down to the close shot, put that to a 60. Driving layup has to be a 90. It cannot go anything higher than that. Then when it comes down to the driving dunk, this is going to be an 89 if you go anything higher than that. It's going to change up the build name. And then when it comes to the post control, go ahead and put this to an 89. That's going to give us 23 badges right there. So super solid when it comes down to the finishing. Now, when it comes down to that mid-range shot, go ahead and put it to an 82. Do not go anything higher than this or else the build name is going to change. Then when it comes down to that free throw, put it to a 72 and max out that three-pointer for another 23 badges, y'all. Now, when it comes down to the pass accuracy, go ahead and put this to a 64. Max out your ball handle as well as your speed with ball, and we're going to be able to get 20 playmaking badges. Now, when it comes down to the defensive side, this is what's really going to put the build together nice. Interior defense, go ahead and put that to a 65. Perimeter defense cannot go anything higher than a 77. And then when it comes down to the steal, you have to keep that at an 87. If you go anything higher, the build name is going to change. But honestly, that's going to be okay because it's going to match up with the block at an 87 as well. Now, when it comes down to the rebounding, offensive is going to be brought up to a 52 and the defensive an 82 for 23 badges right there and 20 for the playmaking. Now, when it comes to the physicals, max out your speed and acceleration. Then go ahead and skip over your strength, and the vertical is going to be put to a 79 and the stamina an 86, y'all. But if you want to, you can go ahead and put this to an 80 and get extra attribute points in certain areas. But again, I do not want to risk losing out on making this a usable build, especially when it comes down to that vertical and the stamina. You definitely want to keep it on how I kept it. But just remember, then again, it's all going to be based off of your personal preference, y'all. So when it comes down to the takeovers, slashing, shot creating, sharp shooting, and then the post scoring, y'all. I feel like the post scoring on this build makes it that much more unique. It's going to be really solid, especially if it's in the right hands. The first takeover that I'm going to go with, though, is going to be limitless range. To make this build more rare and unique, I would definitely go ahead and consider one of the post scoring, but to make it more comp, you could go with the slashing or even double up on the sharp shooting. I'm going to go with finishing moves, and as y'all can see, like I said, we have made the best well-rounded wing, y'all. And I really like these comparisons. Jimmy Butler, Scottie Pippen, and Jaylen Brown, all gonna be some really nice things about it. But let's go ahead and just take a quick look at this build. Okay, so once we get to 99, we do not get a +4. But consider running with teammates that are going to be running defensive leader as well as floor general. And then from there, we have our plus four. Now, the reason why I always bring that up is because for myself, I always run with a teammate that is going to be running floor general. So when it comes down to these stats, driving layup is going to be in the mid to high 90s. Driving dunk, same exact thing, and the same can be said for the post control. Then when it comes down to that shooting, this is going to be able to hit the 90s when it comes down to the mid-range shot. Three-pointer has the potential to hit that high 80s, and then the free throw is going to be in the 80s as well. Now, with the ball handle, this is definitely going to go over the top, somewhere around the 90 range, and then the speed with ball is going to be in the mid to high 80s. From there onto the defensive, the interior, definitely going to be in the 70s, perimeter defense, mid to high 80s, and then when it comes to that steal and block, I really feel like these are going to be more so around the 95 range. But when it comes down to the defensive rebound, this is definitely going to be able to hit the 90s as well. And for our physicals, these are going to be getting that plus four for the gym rat badge. So remember to take all things into consideration when it comes down to making this kind of rare build. Because again, I'm going to be bringing y'all builds that are definitely going to be usable, especially in the way that I make them myself. So when it comes down to this badge count, I'm telling you, if you want to go ahead and follow along, this is something that I would really go with myself. Posterizer on silver, Lob City finisher on gold. And the reason why I put it on gold instead of the normal bronze is because I really feel like the alley-oops are going to need a buff as much as they can, especially when it comes down to the dunking, because now you are literally timing your dunks, y'all. In my opinion, I really think that's a W, because a lot of people would just be driving to the rim at ease without suffering any type of consequences. So with next gen, you actually have to time it, which is going to be perfect to even out the balance. Now, Fearless Finisher is a badge that I like to run. Put Back Boss, you can even consider that. But definitely go ahead and put on Limitless Takeoff. Now, let's go ahead and get into the shooting. 23 badges to work with. So the first one that I'm going to hit y'all with is going to be Silver Hot Zone Hunter. From there, we got a couple of other badges you have to consider as well. Blinders on Silver, and then Bronze Clutch Shooter. Now, when it comes down to these last 16, you can really go ahead and put them on based off your own preference. But for me, I like Catch and Shoot on Silver. Same thing goes for Corner Specialist, Limitless Spot Up. And then when it comes down to these last six, you can definitely go ahead and put it on a Hall of Fame badge if you want to. But in my opinion, spreading the wealth is going to be much more worth it. So I'm going to go with Deadeye as well as Green Machine, y'all. And again, you might be wondering, why do I like to spread the wealth when it comes to certain categories? Because they are going to give you a huge boost. For example, when it comes to your shooting, or even on the defensive side of things. But now let's go ahead and use these 20 badges on the playmaking side. First, I'm going to go ahead and hit y'all with Quick First Step on Silver. I would really consider Stop and Go, but for now, I'm going to go ahead and put on Unpluckable on Bronze. With these last 16, another one that I really like, Handles for Days on Silver. Then from here, we have Triple Threat Juke as well. So if you want to go ahead and put on the most badges that are definitely going to help you out, honestly, Downhill is going to be another one, y'all. Especially if you go with it on Hall of Fame, going to make a huge difference. But for now, I'm going to go ahead and put on Hyperdrive. Stop and Go, like I said, is considerable. But again, it's really just going to come down to which badges you'd like to use more based off of your own preference. Now, for me, I like to go ahead and put on badges that are going to be unlocking certain animations or giving me a boost when it comes down to my physical stats. Whether that be making me feel faster or play better defense, I'm definitely going to go ahead and go with that route. Now, let's go ahead and get into the defensive side of things. So first, I'm going to hit y'all with Intimidator on Gold, Silver Rebound Chaser, and then Bronze Chased on Artist, just to get those animations unlocked. Now, Rim Protector is the same exact thing, but we're going to max it out at Silver. And then when it comes down to the clamps, put this on Silver as well, and we are left with 9 remaining badges. If you want to, go ahead and put on Menace, even though it's only on Silver. Definitely going to be making a huge difference with what you're going to be doing when it comes down to this build. So for the last 5, I'm going to go ahead and put on Pick Dodger. Ankle Brace is going to be another really good one. And then when it comes down to Interceptor, y'all, this one is definitely going to be very helpful, especially for those passing lanes. But again, you can go ahead and put it whatever tier you like the most. I like Pickpocket as well. And this is something of the final setup that I would go with when it comes down to the defensive side. We got 23 badges on the defensive, 20 for the playmaking, 23 on the shooting, and then 23 for the finishing. Man, I know I always say this, but thank y'all so much to those of y'all who made it to the end. Thank God for giving me this opportunity. And just know, I'm going to continue to drop daily uploads like I have been for the past year and over, y'all. So again, I just want y'all to know that I love y'all. I appreciate y'all. But man, y'all already know what y'all need to do. Be sure to hit that sub button if you're new. Anybody who wants to join the Rich Gang family, RGF, go ahead and hit that like button, but do not forget to hit that post notification button as well. Let's go ahead and get 50 likes on this banger. I know that we can do it. I'm going to be talking to y'all tomorrow. Let me know what kind of builds y'all want. Go ahead and drop down a comment, and I most definitely got y'all. But man, with all that being said, I got one last thing to say. Thank God, and Rich out.